What's good, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another episode of Madden. How to make a nigga play that episode. We have the fucking Miami. It's awesome. We got a game. Oh, let's go, man.
The veteran Dustin Hopkins has this one teed up, and we are underway here in Cleveland. Braxton Berrios now from his end zone. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. They'll run here with Raheem Mostert and give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
And from the 34, here's second and four. White. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
Now White. Oh, that's in a double coverage and intercepted. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard
line. Get down.
That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid, a turnover on the first possession.
I love how you use those college-bound words like that, inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that. But here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well. That interception early, they may rethink how they go about attacking.
And now with the play clock getting down, Kevin Stefanski going to take a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. First down, they'll run with Chubb, and they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. Now second and nine. Here's Flacco. He's going to drop this one down for Chubb, and he's got this down to the 35. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12.
I have to tell you, Brandon, I feel like a coach right now because I'm wondering why the angle route continues to be so effective when, as an inside linebacker, you're always taught, don't let someone cross your face. If they want to go outside, it's okay. But they make that outside fake, cut back inside, often to great success.
They'll come up second and seven. Watson now to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Hopkins' kick is good. And the Browns are out to a 3-0 lead. So a pretty good opening drive that'll make the home fans somewhat happy. They wanted six, but they got three in the early lead.
And they should be happy. The guys look good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope. The good things are in store here today for him.
And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Their second drive here, the ball game charge. Remember last time they threw the interception, but the defense held up. It bent a little but didn't break, only giving up the 3 points.
Yeah, obviously they left some points on the table there their last time out, but boy, they have to thank their defense for holding the opposition just 3 after they threw the pick. Their turn now, back out on the field, put together a good drive, and get some points of their own.
To the air on second down. White and going deep for Hill. And that's caught inside the 35. It's a big play there for Miami. 52 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
On first and 10, White. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Saints back at the 31. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. White's throw caught by his receiver, Hill. So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and that's gonna lead to a third and 11. Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. White on third and long. Tyreek Hill's got another one. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage as shown by that last play.
And a pickup of about 4 down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. It's Dolphins football here as we begin the second quarter. Facing a 2nd and 6 from the 8. As they've got it as we resume action. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. So it's 3rd and 6, and this will be the 8th play of the drive. Not liking the look, they'll change the play. To throw, White. And that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed 1 conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
The kick by Sanders is good, and the Dolphins are going to tie the score at 3. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
The Browns drive about to get started. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. Throw left side is complete on the diving effort. They go up the middle with Chubb. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
Now that was an excellent run, and when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job, and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block, but the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
Now after the run by Hunt, here's 1st and 10. From the gun, they'll try to run it.
And some strong running there as he's down just shy of the 20 on the edge of the red zone. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. The handoff to Ford up the middle, and he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it. It's second down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Second and eight coming from the 19. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Now Watson. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. Gonna need something special here on third and long. After that sack, what does Watson have in his arsenal? They'll drop to throw. Forced out to his left. Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line. Had some good yardage there, too, before he fumbled that football, Charles.
Yeah, just think about it this way. Running backs, as a general rule, they kind of know when the end of a run is near. And you notice how they cover up, right? They protect the football. Sometimes quarterbacks forget that out in the open field. After a while, you start to wonder, does the running back coach visit the quarterback?
Now White lost the football. And this ball recovered by the offense. But remember, they cannot advance it here in the final 2 minutes of the half. So this will be blown dead, and it'll come back to the spot of the fumble. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. White looks to throw. He'll let this go deep for Waddle. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsom.
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Yeah, easy to second guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break.
Yeah, I think at the half, the head coach just says, look, that's on me. I wanted to press it, but it's because I believe in you guys.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and ten. Now it's Watson. Flushed out right. He's got his receiver, Cooper. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. A kicker fest so far, all points via field goals. They're hoping to change that right here. Chubb fighting, but he won't get too far. Maybe a yard, that's all, down to the two. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On second down, here's Watson. And he will not get away. He's sacked back around the three-yard line. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half.
When you're this close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense. So the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making them sweat out the final few ticks here of the second quarter. The Miami defense trying to keep them out. They haven't let them in yet. Can they hold again here on third and goal? And Cooper will go in motion. Now Watson on third and goal. under pressure, and they got to him again. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second half ready to roll. Two field goals, a combined output in half number one. Could be first touchdown wins. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Cleveland offense ready to go.
Well, the first half, very even. I mean, really, in all facets, this ball game tied, Charles. So as we start the third quarter, curious to see what the second half brings us.
Certainly am. I'm with you on that one. And we all know a lot of coaches from the NFL all the way down to the peewee level. They love to spin it to their teams. Hey, we're starting a brand new shorter ball game. It's all even. Let's go out and seize it. This is ours.
So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. From the gun, it's a give to Chubb, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now Flacco. And he gets it to his running back, Nick Chubb. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. From the gun, Flacco. And he'll get this one to Cooper, complete. And he's going to be taken down, but there's a penalty flag in the backfield. Is this a hold, or did they rough the quarterback? So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line.
They're looking at a second and 8 now from the 10.
Here's Watson being chased out left and just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one. Deshaun Watson, so multi-dimensional, able to scramble for the first.
Ford is into the end zone for a Browns touchdown.
Sometimes offense can get too cute down near the goal line, but there's nothing fancy about this one.
As Coach it's top five said, game, bro.
We get a seal wow. Here, and we get a seal here.
That's a top five game.
In the alley, and that's good work at the line and finishing the end zone.
This is a good ass game right here. This is a good ass game right here, bro. Defense on defense.
Touchdown,
and like this one, wow, shit! I haven't played a game
this one, wow. The goal line, but the fair catch means this drive will begin at the 25.
Yeah.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. But Charles, you and I said at intermission, feels like we're set up for a good second half. Well, the other side scored, and now it's up to them to answer. How do they respond here with their first drive of the second half?
Well, bottom line is, they just saw the ball go in the end zone against their defense, and they saw what good offense looks like. They believe they've got a good offense as well.
Defense,
boy. The best plays you got to the top performers
defense.
You have, and try to move that ball down the field for an answering score.
Second down, it's White. He'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Throwing on first down, White. He'll let this go deep for Waddle.
Let me get that little brother. Let me get that little brother. Let me get that little brother. Defense, baby. Defense, baby. Defense, baby. offense, baby. Let me get that, little brother. Let me get that. You about to put Tua back in? Let me get that. Let me get that. We need that. We need that, little brother. Defense, baby. Defense, baby. Defense, baby. Woo! His defense is... Oh, shit, his defense is good, too. God damn it.
The Browns drive about to get started. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb.
We gotta cut, baby. We gotta cut. Gotta cut.
Now to this point.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he'll get it down here to the 43. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. More the motion man. On first down, Watson.
Damn it, I knew that was about to happen.
Team, it's intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. Down the right side.
I knew that was about to fucking happen. I knew it.
Pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Well, that's what you get, apparently, when you try to take
defense,
off.
Defense, man. I knew it was about to happen. Wrong fucking player.
Bring it back for six.
Teams absolutely stay away from throwing the ball at him. Here he's just
fucking defense, bro.
Makes a great play on the football and turns it into six.
All level now at 10.
Stop all that shit, Jamie. Damn. Away. What the fuck?
Good
fucking
height,
man. Fuck.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. So both teams trade touchdowns, and the third is worth through three quarters of play. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They go with Chubb on second down. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Flacco. Cooper, and take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Now a first down throw, Watson. Slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. He'll get eight on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple. They give the Chubb out of the gun. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Clock running under four to play now as they come up on first and 10. To pass, Flacco drops it off for Chubb, and it's a run to run now, and they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. They'll get set to the 17, and it's a first down.
I tell you what, it looks like he's shaking off that pick six just fine. It's not just defensive backs that have to have short memories. Quarterbacks utilize that as well. A much more confident throw right there.
Cooper will come in motion right. From the red zone now, Watson. Flush to his right. He rifles complete, caught by Moore. And the Browns are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the five.
That's a big league job there of getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
A field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. They'll run with Chubb. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Only a yard that time. Second and goal. Chubb again. And he takes this one in for a Brown score. Nick Chubb taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Browns have broken our tie and have taken a fourth quarter lead.
And this is a time of game where offensive lines can really dictate a team's fortunes. It's been a tough battle. They've been out there for a long time. But this was a question of who can wear down who. And that's excellent work to put a long drive together and finish it with a touchdown run to take the lead.
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one-possession game, down eight. They'll be looking for the touchdown and two-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage. Well, that's where this Cleveland crowd, the dog pound in particular, make it difficult on opposing offenses. It looked like they might have had troubles communicating at the line, and it leads to the incompletion. Second and 10 from the 25. Here's White. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out high. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
The Dolphins on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10.
Let me get that up, brother. Let me get that up, brother. You don't need it. Let me get that up, brother. Defense! Let me get that up, brother. You don't need it, sir. You don't need it, sir! Stop playing with me! Let go, man! Defense! 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 Fuck your Tyree Hill, nigga. Defense.